Hi, it's Bruce Alexander, BruceAtTheBeach.net. Peanut and I are out here this Saturday afternoon. It's a little breezy, so I'm holding on to her. If you haven't watched this broadcast before, we do these YouTube programs every Saturday. It's just an effort by me to make you a more educated buyer. And what we talk about as far as buying real estate down here at the beach applies at home wherever you are. And just don't place 100% of your trust in your realtor. Now, that may sound funny coming from a broker, but there are some great agents down here, great real estate companies. There's some in your hometown as well. But there's some agents that are real nitwits wherever. And unfortunately, you don't find out until it's too late in many cases. I want to educate you and give you a fighting chance so that you get the very best deal possible. What we're covering today is 18 properties down here at the beach. Not sold by me, but by realtors down here, beach-related properties. First one, we have 18 today. Now, if you are new to the broadcast, I cover, if you go to BruceAtTheBeach.net and go to recent sold prices, the listing sheets for that particular week, this particular week, there's 18 of them that sold. And I mark down there, you can download these, takes about 2 or 3 minutes. I cover the days on the market, the market price, which is the comps, the comparable sales in the building for the last year, and translate it into a cost per square foot basis. Same thing with the price, what it sold for on a cost per square foot basis. That's the yardstick or the ruler that we measure value with down here. Because if you're looking at a particular property or a particular unit in a given building, that's how we measure value. First one is a home on Ono Island, and it's a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, listed at $279,000, sold at $227,000. Market in for that type of property, it's about 2,000 square foot, three bedroom, two bath on Ono. Market's $128 a square foot. This sold for $114 a square foot. It's a good deal. The next one is, for those of you who are following, we deleted 2 of 18. This is 3 of 18. The Island Sunrise and Gulf Shores, a condo project right on the beach. List price $170,000, sold for $172,200. Now, that's more than the listed price. You got investors down here that see a good deal and they step up to the plate. Sometimes they pay $5,000 or $10,000 more because it's it provides good value. The market in this particular building is $211 a square foot. This one sold at $191 a square foot. So even though he paid, or whoever the buyer was, paid over the listing price, it was still $20 a square foot under market. The next one is, and that was a short sale. The next one, for those of you that have downloaded, if you see REO, that's bank term for real estate owned. That's a foreclosure property. That's one that the bank is foreclosed on. This is at Sun Chase in Gulf Shores. $87,900 was the listing price. $87,900 was the selling price. You know, folks, this is the gold standard is on the beach, just like right here. And but these older properties in Gulf Shores, that this was built in 1984, that's about 600 square foot, 2-bedroom, 1-bath. I mean, they, even though they're an older property, they provide good value. I mean, a 2-bedroom, 1-bath for less than $90,000, probably 50 yards from the beach. The market in that building was $184 a square foot. This one sold at $133 a square foot. A good deal. You can make some money on rental with that unit. It's breezy out here this afternoon. The next one is 5 of 18. It's Windward Point, listed at 300,000, sold at 300,000, three bedroom, two bath. Market in the building, and this was a short sale. Market in the building's $239. This is pretty much on the money at $238 a square foot in the selling price. The next one is 6 of 18, Showalter in Orange Beach. Nice complex, three bedroom, two bath. Listed at $299,900, sold at $280,000. The market in that building's $231 a square foot. This sold for $224 a square foot, a whisker under market. The next one is the Beach Club out on up in Fort Morgan. Nice complex. This was a one bedroom, one bath, listed at $180,000, sold at $178,000. Market in that building is $251 a square foot. This was a short sale and sold at $265 a square foot. It's a little more than I would have paid for it. Although sometimes people fall in love with a property and pay more than they should. That's just up to the buyer. Tradewinds in Orange Beach. This is 8 of 18. List price, $250,000. Sold at $217,000. Market in that building is $215 a square foot. This sold pretty much on the money at $217 a square foot. The next one is 9 of 18. We're going to have to stop the shooting if the wind blows these sheets down the beach. 9 of 18, Phoenix 6, $379,500, sold for $345,000. It's a three-bedroom, two-bath. Market in that building is $265 a square foot. Poured concrete building. The Phoenix buildings are rental machines. This sold at $248 a square foot. Goodbye. Next one is Escapes to the Shore in Orange Beach. Listed at $542,000, sold at $467,500. Two bedroom, two bath. I looked at that and I thought, whoa, that is way overpriced. But as I did my research on it, I found, and this building is fairly unique in that it has a lot of timeshares in it, and there are connected units. This was a two-bedroom, two-bath, but it was connected to a one-bedroom, one-bath with an adjoining door, like an old motel, although this is a newer building, built in 2008. That $467,500 included the one bedroom as well. So market price in that building is $218 a square foot. This sold a $206, which is a good buy. It was only on the market one day, and that's why. Next one is Gulf Shores. It's the Sea Wind Complex, an upscale complex. This is a two-bedroom, two-bath. It was listed at $255,000 and it sold at $275,000, $20,000 over the listing price. Remember what I said. If it's a good value or if it's a good unit, and this is an upscale building, market in that building, they've had a number of foreclosures, is $231 a square foot. This is $243 a square foot. But if you can buy a two-bedroom, two-bath in a newer poured concrete building on the beach, something built in the last 4 or 5 years for that 250, in that 250 range, 260, even 275, you can make the cash flow numbers work on that. Next one, 12 of 18, is the San Carlos, another upscale new building in Gulf Shores. Listed at $289,000, sold at $284,000. It was a two-bedroom, two-bath. Market in that building is $256 a square foot. This was a good buy. This sold at $231 a square foot. Next one is Turquoise. It's a high-end complex. The units were designed to sell for $1.2 to $5 million, but it came out of the ground right at the wrong time, right as the market was starting to turn. They have started to take trades in there, and I see that the pattern, there were three sold last week and a couple sold a week or so before that. The pattern is they're selling at 925,000, listed at 925,000. They're typically on the market one day, and but last week, and as I said, they're taking trades. Now, the way it looks based on last week's sales is if you don't have a trade, you can buy that for 725,000. They say it's VP money that's going to it. I don't know about that, but if you pay cash, it's 725. If you trade in your beach unit on it, then it's 925. Kind of just like buying a used car, kind of an over allowance based on the unit you have. For the one that this sold at 402, the one last week at 725,000 sold at $315 a square foot. That's a big difference. Next one is also in Orange Beach, 14 of 18. It's 210,000. It's at the Harbor Place. 210,000 sold at 159,000. This is right next to the Hilton Garden Inn. Two bedroom, two bath on the beach. Market's $180 a square foot. This is this sold at $182 a square foot. Quite a few foreclosures in there. About $159,000 for a two-bedroom on the beach. I mean, these prices aren't going to go to zero. That's just a good deal. Now, this next one was a bad deal for the investor, and I know the doctor that bought this originally. We're on 15 of 18. This is at the Opal, a high-end complex on the beach in Orange Beach, five bedroom, five bath. Now the Opal is about 15 stories or thereabouts, and each floor is a complete unit. So there's 15 units in the building, it's a 15 story building. This was probably in pre-construction over $2 million. Listing price, it's a short sale. That's a big short sale. $1,975,000 is the listing price. It sold for $950,000. They took $1 million loss, over $1 million loss on that property. If this is the neighborhood that you travel in, $1 million properties, give me a call, because there's some screaming deals down here. Market in that building is $323 a square foot. This sold at $219 a square foot. Very, very nice units. Next one is 16 of 18 Bayshore Towers on the Back Bay off Canal over near Sportsman's Marina. Listed at $549,900, sold at $505,000. It's a three bedroom, three bath Bayshore Towers. Market in that building is $195 a square foot. This sold at $229 a square foot. That's certainly more than I would have paid for it, considering that there's foreclosures in the building about the same size for $250,000. Anyway, next one, that would not be a good deal in my book. Next one is 17 of 18 Surfside Shores in Gulf Shores. It's a three bedroom, three bath. It's listed at $274,000, sold at $261,500. Market in that building is $258 a square foot. This sold at $249 a square foot, which is a reasonable deal. Next one, the last one, is the Colonnades, nice complex built in 2006, four bedroom, four bath, listed at $585,000, sold at $552,000. Market in that building is $252 a square foot. And this sold at $258 a square foot, just a whisker over market. Now, if you have any questions, and you're interested, or you have any questions about real estate at all, it's Bruce at the Beach at gmail.com. If you want to give me a call, my phone number is all over my website. Give me a call. I'd like to talk real estate with you. If you have any questions, just let me know. Have a great week. Come on down to the beach. This we've had some cold weather down here the last week. Today it's today. It's in the mid-50s, a little breezy this afternoon, but it's supposed to be in the 60s, maybe 70 by the end of the week. We got the seagulls coming in. Anyway, have a great week. Come on down to the beach, and we'll talk to you next Saturday morning.